In this video, I'm going to be demonstrating anatomical structures related to dental anesthesia. So the first structure we're going to look at is the vestibule. So our vestibule, we have a maxillary vestibule and we have a mandibular vestibule. And so that's going to be where we're going to administer the majority of our dental anesthesia injections. So you want to be able to identify the vestibule, and most importantly, you want to be able to identify the height of the vestibule. So the height of the vestibule is going to be where the vestibule starts to curve a little bit. So right at the top of the vestibule where it starts to curve, let me get a little better retraction there. So you can kind of see where that starts to bowl out and curve a little bit. That's going to be the height of the vestibule right in there. And the same thing on the lower, if you're to identify the height of the vestibule on the bottom, right where it starts to curve up into the lip there or the cheek. So you want to be able to identify height of vestibule. Zygomatic process, so you can palpate the zygomatic process generally starting way back here in the molar area. So you're going to feel way up in the height of the vestibule. You can feel that bone, and if you palpate it anteriorly, you'll feel it kind of goes away right about the spot where our MSA or middle superior anterior alveolar injection is going to be given. So right about in here. So you want to be able to palpate for that bone, the zygomatic process, the zygomatic bone, because that can interfere. You may hit that bone if you don't identify where it's at and where it stops on either your MSA injection or possibly even your PSA injection way in the back there. Another structure we want to be able to identify is the alveolar process of bone. So that's our alveolar process of bone. And we want to be in the height of the vestibule so that we avoid hitting that alveolar process of bone or potentially even the periosteum underneath. The next structure we're going to identify is the canine eminence. So that is this prominence of bone that's right above the canine, and that's going to be significant for our ASA or anterior superior alveolar injection. So there's the canine eminence. The maxillary tuberosity is going to be way in the back. I'll have you shift your jaw just a little bit and then turn away. Perfect. And so our tuberosity is going to be this piece of bone way in the back here, and we're going to be kind of distal and behind that bone when we give our PSA injection. Our incisive papilla is going to be way anterior, in between the two maxillary central teeth. So this little kind of mushroom of tissue, let me get my light a little bit better. There, now we can really see the incisive papilla, so you can see right here this nice little teardrop-shaped piece of tissue. So you can see the widest part of the papilla down here is where we're going to give our nasal palatine injection to numb the anterior palate. So that's our incisive papilla. And then for the greater palatine foramen, to identify the GP foramen, what I like to do is you want to start palpating around the area of the first molar, and you want to start palpating about midway between the midpalatal suture and the gingival margin in line with about the first molar, and you start to palpate back until you start to feel your cotton tip kind of sink in. So here we can feel a little depression right here. On some individuals, you might see a little blue area of tissue because it's highly vascular, but you'll be able to see that depression. I like to call it like a trampoline. You can see it kind of push in and sponge back out. So that's going to be the area for our GP greater palatine injection. Now we're going to look at a couple structures that help us for the mandibular injection. So I'm just going to adjust my light again here. Thank you. And so for the inferior alveolar injection, some of the structures we want to identify, you can go ahead and swallow, sorry. Thank you. Some of the structures we want to identify are going to be the pterygomandibular raphe. So you can see this is the pterygomandibular raphe. So it starts right behind the molar, the last molar, the terminal molar. and then extends all the way up, and it blends here then into the palate. So we want to identify that because that's going to help us determine where our IA injection will be. We want to hug the raphe when we give that injection. And then you can see I'm kind of bringing my finger out here. My retraction finger is in the coronoid notch. So if you feel the inside of the cheek, along the inside of the cheek, you'll feel that that bone, the mandibular bone, and the deepest point of that bone is going to be our coronoid notch, and that's going to help us determine the height of our injection for the inferior alveolar nerve block. We want to be at least halfway above the or halfway of the length of the raphe, and our coronoid notch pretty much pushes right about halfway, maybe a little higher, which is ideal for that injection technique. The last structure we want to identify is our mental foramen. So the mental foramen is going to be usually between the two premolars on the mandible. And you can use your panoramic image or any x-rays, periapical images, to help you identify where that might be. But again, we want to be in the height of the mucobuccal fold, and then it's going to be in between the two premolar areas. So let me get a little bit more light in there maybe for you all to see that better. There we go. And so right at the height. And this one, it almost looks like we're out into the lip a little bit when we give this injection to avoid, again, the periosteum. So those are some significant anatomical structures for dental anesthesia.